The views expressed on the following program do not necessarily reflect the views of Money Radio staff, management, or advertisers, and do not represent an offer to buy or sell any securities. Some interviews heard on this program may be sponsored by the participants. It's time for Health Futures with Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth. This is Arizona's only show dedicated to providing you with expert advice on how to live a longer, healthier, and happier life. To learn more, call 602-264-8009. That's 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Bob Roth.
Good afternoon. You're listening to Health Futures, taking stock in you. I'm your host, Bob Roth, and it must be Friday, and indeed it is. We're coming at you live from the Scottsdale Park Studios of Money Radio, 1510 AM, 105.3 FM, and the World Wide Web, moneyradio1510.com. If this is the first time you're tuning into our show is about how our older adult population can live a healthier, happier life. How do we do this? We do this by bringing extraordinary guests to the show. And today is no different. I have an incredible guest here in the studio with me. This is Dr. Rory Murphy. He is an independent neurosurgeon at Honor Health Deer Valley Medical Center. He's also a brain and spine neurosurgeon, independent member of Honor Health medical staff. Dr. Murphy, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, Bob.
Can I call you Rory?
Yes.
Rory, welcome to the show. Brain... Neuro work, I mean, that goes really hand in glove with the audience that we talk to and certainly the audience that we serve. And I certainly have some family members. One that I think of is my dad, who is dealing with spinal stenosis. I would imagine you see a lot of older adults.
Yes, Sam, Bob. We see across the age group, we see younger patients obviously involved with brand new spinal cord injuries and fractures, generally from activities like motorbike riding, driving cars, and horseback riding. And then in slightly older population, we have people having falls and developing gradual wear and tear that can actually present with symptoms that they may not actually realize are chronic or slow onset spinal cord injuries. So we see it's a very common issue. We're seeing more and more of it all the time.
Well, you know what? I would love for you to tee it up and tell us a little bit about your background and your training. And I know you're somewhat new here, so please introduce our listeners to Dr. Rory Murphy.
Yes. So I'm a neurosurgeon with the Barrow Brain and Spine Group, and I operate predominantly in Deer Valley, Honor Health Deer Valley.
Yep.
And I've been in Phoenix for about 4 years now. Time flies. My main passion is spinal cord injuries and how we can help people when they have a spinal cord injury and recover from a spinal cord injury and how to prevent them as well. And since I've been here, I've noticed some unique aspects of Phoenix and Arizona. There are a lot of people, unfortunately, sustain spinal cord injuries here. It's a mixture of the high-speed freeways around here. I guess people are very active and fit here and engage in horseback riding, motorcycling, and climbing and other adventure sports.
Right.
So we see more and more brand new acute spinal cord injuries than most places in the U.S. And also, a lot of people come here fit and healthy and retire here, and they do develop wear and tear of their spine that can slowly pinch their spinal cord and present with symptoms that don't really realize is a spinal cord injury, but they might start to have problems walking or falling and then have falls and worsen that spinal cord injury and then present to the hospital. So I'd love to chat about how we can recognize those signs and symptoms early to prevent problems in the future.
Oh, absolutely. And for our listeners, I detect a little bit of an accent. Can you tell us a little bit about where you're from and your training and where you were educated?
Yes. So I was born and raised in Cork in Ireland and went to university there and then came over to the U.S. To get training because the neurosurgery training in the U.S. is the best in the world.
It's nice to know that.
Yes. So a period of time in the Midwest in WashU in St. Louis and then San Francisco for my fellowship. And then I was fortunate to get a position here 4 years ago. And it's just been great being here and such a surrounded by such pragmatic people and quite fit, active people too.
And you were mentioning that. I mean, I think that's the greatest thing about living out in the West is that we are active. We do a lot of things outdoors. And, you know, it's really nice to hear that, you know, look, you may have some degenerative stuff. You may have some injuries, but it's not the end of the world. Yeah. And knowing that you have this practice and the work that you do is incredibly rewarding and knowing that it is there.
Yes, and there's more and more people having these issues. So famous examples would be Elon Musk would have had neck surgery in approximately 2 years ago. Peyton Manning from football. Mm-hmm. And other, I guess, older examples like Michael Collins, the astronaut, would have had neck surgery. And there's many, many more people who have had neck surgery. Michael Fox would have had neck surgery. So it is very common. It's something, when dealt with correctly, people can really improve their quality of life and can really manage well. If they manage it well, can really invest in their future health.
No, I love that. And I really like the fact that you have this partnership with the Barrow Group. And I mean, that's world renowned, and Honor Health obviously is an entity we all know here. I think that bringing the two together is incredibly rewarding for our community.
Yes, and it really helps people.
Sure. So, you know, my audience knows that we talk about aging. So, you know, I'm going to ask you a question. We may not get to the entire answer because we're coming up on the first segment. But, you know, when we age, obviously, we run into hazards that weren't hazards when we were younger, right? You know, we think we're invincible and we think we can do the things that we used to be able to do, like swinging our golf clubs or even an entryway rug that, you know, we might lose our balance and may result in a fall or maybe a brain injury. Can you talk us through, you know, some of the common spinal cord injuries that you're seeing and what is happening amongst our aging population?
Yes. So I think some symptoms that you should be, you need to get looked into and you need to be aware of. So everyone has neck pain. Everyone will have neck pain during their life. That is common. There's nothing to be worried about. Most of the time it gets better within a month or two, or time improves it. However, if you start to have, you know, trouble with your hands, dropping items with your hands, getting unsteadier when you're walking, falling or tripping more frequently, or having numbness and tingling down your arms, those are potential signs of slow compression of your spinal cord and your neck from wear and tear. And you do need to go to your primary care physician and maybe a neurologist or a neurosurgeon for further assessment.
No, that's good to know. I mean, certainly, you know, like you said, I have neck pain. And if it goes away, no biggie. But like you said, if you start to have some numbness and some of the symptoms that you're talking about,
exactly,
you need to see your PCP.
People often downplay it. So they might say it's clumsiness or getting a bit slower. If you are getting slower, having dropping items with your hands, having trouble with doing your buttons up or writing, those are things that need to be looked into.
Sure. I mentioned golf. I mean, we live in the golfing mecca of this country right here in Arizona, in Scottsdale and Phoenix. I mean, I think there are over 100 golf courses here. And I would imagine that the golf swing, puts an incredible torque on your spine.
Yes, some of my colleagues have published on that and evaluated that more. It definitely does in your lower back. Your neck generally, thankfully, the forces aren't as strong on the neck. Some people will notice that they'll have trouble going the full 18 holes of golf. That's a classic thing we talk about in clinic. You know, how many rounds of golf were you playing a year ago, 2 years ago? Often people say, look, I can barely do a hole because I can't walk. Or when I'm walking up hills on the green, I'm very unsteady. That's, you know, that shouldn't be really happening.
Sure.
Especially if it wasn't happening a year ago.
Well, exactly. And that torque that you put on, I mean, look, you know, we all know Tiger Woods. And, you know, even he is not invincible. And he has had to undergo surgeries not only on his knee but on his back. And And now we don't know what's going to happen with his foot, but hopefully he makes a comeback. He's kind of a fan favorite.
I'm sure he will.
And I'm a golfer, so I like following that. Well, listen, Dr. Rory Murphy, he's here in the studio. We're talking neurology. We're talking brain. We're talking spine. Stick around. We got one segment down. We got three more to go. We'll be right back.
Now back to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. You're listening to Health Futures, Taking Stock in You. I'm your host, Bob Roth. We're on our second segment. If you are just tuning in, I have got Dr. Rory Murphy here in the studio. He's a brain and spine neurosurgeon. He's an independent member of the Honor Health medical staff. And we are talking about backs primarily and necks. And if you missed that first segment, you can catch it up on our website at cypresshomecare.com. Click on the media button. Third button down is radio show. You'll catch this one and many, many more. You know, during the break, we were talking about our highways. And we were talking about some of the stuff that you see. And, you know, you see so much more than the general public does. You know, can you share with our listeners some of the stuff that you're seeing as it relates to the highways in terms of car crashes and motorcycles?
Yes. One of the first things I noticed here was, unfortunately, there are a lot of people here who sustain injuries and spinal cord injuries and fractures, which is more than anywhere else in the U.S. And I think it's because
people anywhere else in the U.S. Listeners, hear that. I mean, that's, you know, Arizona is known for all the not so good things, and this is one of the not so good things.
But I think it's a testament to the people here. People are out horse riding, they're active, they're mountain biking, they're golfing, there are dirt bikes, they're driving classic cars, and they're driving their Harleys, and they're enjoying life. Unfortunately, there are risks involved with that, and we do see more traumatic spinal cord injuries and specifically neck injuries in certain locations in Phoenix than most places in the U.S. Thankfully, we've got lots of ways to help. One of my main passions is trying to help people after spinal cord injuries, brand new spinal cord injuries. And so the Department of Defense actually looked at the numbers across the U.S. and they noticed that in Phoenix and some of the centers we are in, including Deer Valley, we get more neck fractures than anywhere else in the U.S. So when someone comes in now with the Department of Defense, we are doing a trial where we will cool their spinal cord and try and help them recover. So it came about after a famous football player, Kevin Everett, had an injury and he was assessed, looked after well and operated on well, and his spinal cord was cooled and he made a very good recovery, was able to walk approximately a year after his injury. And
I remember that. And I remember the famous one, Mark Bonacani, Nick Bonacani's son.
Yes.
And they started that research down in Miami.
Exactly. And actually, that's the lead center is University of Miami. So it's Honor Health Deer Valley is one of the centers. University of Emory University, Philadelphia, and Shock Trauma Center in Baltimore. So we have just as many fractures as Shock Trauma Center in Baltimore or Emory University in Atlanta. But it's great for people who have these injuries. We have that opportunity to help them with this new technology or these new opportunities. And some of a lot of our patients are actually from quite far north, so they can still benefit, even though if they live in Minneapolis or Toronto or other locations further north, and they split their time between here and there. We've had some patients from far north with neck fractures, and they've been enrolled into these trials.
And, you know, we talked about football. I mean, do you see much from athleticism? Do you see much from football and other, you know, other stuff at your hospital?
Thankfully not. Okay. I think most team sports are, okay, injuries can happen.
Mm-hmm.
But for the most part, team sports are relatively safe and good for everyone's health.
Good.
Realistically, what do we see more of? We see more of falls from ladders, motorcycle injuries and horse riding injuries, and of course vehicle collisions too. People are you know, people drive, unfortunately, pretty fast around here.
No, they do. And you know, you talked about falls from ladders, and you talk about falls, and that's something that, you know, is near and dear to us with the older adults. And it is amazing. I mean, some of these falls, you know, look like they were in automobile accidents, and they just went from standing upright and going down.
And that's actually very true. It's a very good observation. Unfortunately, as we age, we become less flexible.
Mm-hmm.
And from wear and tear or other conditions, our actual spine starts to stick together a bit. So you don't need as much force to cause a bad fracture. So we're seeing more and more people in their 70s and 80s who are very fit and active. They're riding horses, cycling, doing everything, enjoying life. And they have a fall or a fall from a bicycle, and they actually have severe fractures because their spine doesn't move as flexibly as it would have when they were 18.
Interesting. No, I get that. And, you know, I think that also comes with this generation. And I shared with you at the very beginning, my dad, who is 85 years old, has spinal stenosis. And, you know, part of his challenge is that he led a very sedentary life. That generation, you talked about Arizona, where people are active, they're outdoors. Those are all really great things. But this generation that is in their 70s and 80s and older, they were very sedentary. He sat at a desk for 12 hours a day. And you talk about, you know, the compression of the spine and not being active, all lead to some of the challenges our older adult population's dealing with, right?
Yes, but thankfully most of them can be helped or either helped or delayed or fixed. So people can stay active and moving. There's essentially the main challenge is if you do have wear and tear pressing on your spinal cord, that's a bad issue and that needs to be looked after. Or if you have a fracture, and that is another issue. As you get into your 70s and 80s, your bone not only just becomes stiffer, but unfortunately becomes a bit weaker too. So compression fractures are very common in people in their 70s, 80s, and 90s. So being screened when you're young, in your 40s, 50s, and 60s, and starting medications to improve your bone quality and strengthen your bones is very important.
No, all good stuff. So we've covered a lot about brain and spine injuries and treatment options, but there's more about Honor Health and also more specifically about the research division that is committed to identifying other breakthrough treatment options for these types of injuries. Can you talk to us a little bit about what's going on over at Honor Health?
As we talked about earlier, the Department of Defense trial looking at cooling a spinal cord injury. We're also using different medications to help people with spinal cord injuries, both brand new spinal cord injuries and chronic spinal cord injuries. So we have interactions with multiple groups, including an unusual Mitsubishi, giving medications to help people with spinal cord injuries and other drugs too. And we also have new technologies. So taking the example of Michael Collins, the astronaut, he had a neck surgery where they put in a bone graft and a plate. And that's an excellent surgery. We do it all the time and it really works. But now we do have new technologies like disc replacement systems. So just like you may need your hip replaced or your knee replaced, we can now actually replace discs that are degenerate, that are worn down. Yes. And they work very well. The technology has been out there for about 15, 20 years, predominantly in Europe and came from Europe. So it has been around for 20 years. It's not new. In the US, started to become available about 10 years ago, 15 years ago. But now we've got excellent knowledge and expertise, and there's lots of different new disc replacement devices. So we have some of the newer devices are on trial with the research division.
And when you talk about this, does that a disc replacement like that, that avoids doing fusion, right? If you can replace that disc, you can keep that person more active and more limber. Or do you do fusion at the same time?
It depends on the challenge. And you have to have all these, you have to have a couple of different options because you have to tailor it to what the person's goals are, what right. their symptoms are, and, well, everyone's very different. But you have to have all the options. So for younger, healthier people, sometimes the disc replacements can work really well. Like Elon Musk, he had a disc replacement. But we can also do it in many people who are fit and active in their 70s.
No, it's amazing the breakthroughs that you guys are going through. And, you know, I knew about the spinal cooling piece, and that technology has shown that it does work. I mean, what it does in layman's terms is it stops the inflammation, right?
Correct.
You cool it down, and then you can get right to the root of the injury and do what you can to fix it.
Yes, and it does show promise. Cooling has been used for many other conditions, cardiac and young children as well. And having this option for people with spinal cord injuries and help them recover is great.
Well, I'll tell you what, we're almost at halftime, and there's so much more I want to talk to you about. You know, I want to maybe tee up the third and fourth segments. Do you have anything in particular you want to leave as a tease for our listeners so that they stay tuned to hearing what we're talking about here with Dr. Rory Murphy?
Basically, spine health. We'll chat more about spine health next.
All right. We'll talk about spine health, and we'll talk about really all the great things that is happening over at Honor Health. And Dr. Rory Murphy, thank you for being here in the studio here today. And I do want to add, and maybe we can talk about it just right here at the beginning, is obviously in your specialty, you know, with this COVID-19, this coronavirus going on, you know, we're learning more about brain fog and some of that stuff. You know, I'm catching you by surprise here. I don't know if you have any information on the brain fog and memory lapses, but if you do, we'll talk about that in the second half. You're listening to Health Futures, Taking Stock in You. I'm Bob Roth. I got Dr. Rory Murphy here. Stick around. We'll be right back.
Now back to Health Futures, Taking Stock in You. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. You're listening to Health Futures, Taking Stock in You. I'm your host, Bob Roth, and if you just are tuning in here, I've got Dr. Rory Murphy here in the studio with me. He's an independent neurosurgeon at Honor Health Deer Valley Medical Center. He's also an independent member of the Honor Health medical staff. And if you missed our first half, you got to catch it up on our website. We talked about a lot of things relating to spinal and neck injuries, and we talked about how we in Arizona lead in that area, and a lot of the reasons why is that we are a very active community. So if you want to catch that, go up to cypresshomecare.com. Click on the media button. Third button down is radio show. So when we teed off or when we exited the first half, I talked about brain fog, and I kind of put you on the spot. And I know that this isn't an area that you actually specialize in, but I know that you and I are hearing more and more of this stuff that's happening as relates to COVID. And, you know, it's also new, and we're learning so much. And I don't know if you have anything to add. I don't know if there's anything that is happening to spinal cords or necks as a result of it, but it's a very fluid situation for sure.
Yes, it's a big challenge, Bob, and it is affecting all of us. The one thing I have noticed is, unfortunately, because of concerns about COVID and the system is slowing down somewhat, people aren't getting the care that they need in a timely manner. So people are delaying going to the their primary care doctor, or they're having problems, but they're waiting. They're not right. They're not coming in. And we've seen, especially about 6 months ago, a lot of people that should have gone to, would have come in quicker earlier, delaying their care and coming in, honestly, sicker. So I would say, you know, if you have an issue, your primary care is available, you know, other specialists are available, don't delay. There's no risk with coming in. And we are seeing it more and more. People, they say, I didn't want to come in sooner because I was concerned about different issues, or there was slightly more barriers to getting in than 3 or 4 years ago.
Sure. And what's interesting too is that, I mean, you guys all practice, you know, precautions, you know, masking up, and you certainly have, you know, all those things in place to protect your patients. And and encourage them to definitely come in and see their primary care physicians, but easily to come in and see you for a consultation.
Yes, and all offices are, you know, reducing exposures, keeping, you know, only one or two people in the office to really cut down on the interactions between people. But you should still come in and get looked after. We don't want people delaying their care, delaying diagnosis of tumors or severe spinal cord compression, because the longer you leave it, the tougher it is to fix.
You know, it's interesting when you teed off the first segment you talked about of our show, you talked about all the other hospitals that are in that same category, same league as you guys are, and one of them you mentioned was in Baltimore, shock trauma. I'm originally from Baltimore.
Yes.
And I got to tell you, I mean, shock trauma, Baltimore was like, you know, world renowned. I mean, we're talking about some of the technologies and stuff that they had goes back to the 1970s.
Yes, and physicians from around the world go there to train. I personally went there for a period to learn there. So it has an amazing reputation. The injuries that happen are somewhat similar to here, but different. Here it is more falls, people coming off their bicycles and their horses and sometimes their golf carts. Whereas in Baltimore, it's a more there's more penetrating injuries, so guns and other type of injuries like that. Whereas here, it's a different type of injury, mainly falls.
Sure. My brother a long time ago got a tour. His good friend, his dad was, our grandfather was part of the Board of Regents, and it was more of a precautionary thing because they had an automobile accident. But I remember him telling me, you know, some of the patients that he got to see, and one was in really bad shape. It was a motorcycle accident. And it's stuff that you kind of see almost every day.
And I think, you know, I personally rode a motorbike for many, many years before I came to the U.S. And I think it's a great passion and a great sport. If you drive safely, wear your helmet. The new technology now that can protect the spine is amazing. There's new inflatable suits made by Spidey and other companies.
Wow.
And those suits then that inflate and protect the neck are also available for horse riding and other conditions. You know, people who wear the protective gear do better. So we have super bike riders who come in, they're wearing the protective gear. They may have an injury, but usually it's a injury that they'll recover from pretty quickly and do well. People who don't wear protective gear don't do as well.
Right. I imagine it. You know, look, I understand the thrill of getting behind the bike. And I, too, rode but did dirt biking 45, 50 years ago, a long time ago. But, you know, it's got to be hard to wear all that protective gear when it's 113 degrees outside.
Technology is improving, though. Gore-Tex, breathable materials.
It's good to know.
And, you know, it's always the trip from your home to the local grocery store or somewhere close by. That's when you have your injury.
Sure.
So wearing it close to home is the most important thing, not when you're going on a long ride up to Prescott or up to Flagstaff, but more when you're doing a short ride near your home.
Sure. No, absolutely. You know, we talk about falls, and that's something that's near and dear to us with older adults. And certainly, you know, fall prevention is so important. And it's really important to, you know, and this is something that primary care physicians can look at. You know, you want to take a look at someone's gait, make sure that they're moving and their movement is strong enough to be able to carry them without presenting a fall. But certainly, you know, for our listeners, especially older adults, I mean, concentrating on working on your core and strengthening your glutes and your hamstrings and your quads are so important to prevent falls.
And keep your muscle mass, yes. And just light to moderate weights, simple exercises, swimming, walking, you know, yoga, all these exercises are fantastic. It doesn't require much. But all of this is a great investment because if you keep your muscles strong, if you keep your core strong, that will help you for decades.
No, it's good to know. Certainly, you know, spinal cord injuries, I mean, and neck injuries are something that do happen, and you probably see a lot more with the older adults. But, I mean, there's that prevention piece, and exercise is such a big part of that.
Exactly, and avoiding some dangerous things like ask friends or family for help with things like ladders. That is a common presentation. So we all think we're more we all believe we're stronger or more agile than we really are. You know, really, you know, being careful with ladders is incredibly important.
Well, I'm going to tell you firsthand that I went up on a ladder up in my at the pinnacle of my bedroom and my living room. There's a smoke detector, and it is literally 14 feet, and my ladder is a 10-foot ladder, and I was up there changing it probably not last September, but the September before, and I know it's going to start chirping.
At 1 a.m. probably.
Yes, exactly, and you can't really throw something up there because you're gonna probably scuff and ruin the wall, but I will tell you, I went up and did it, and I said to my wife, Susie, I said, that's it. I'm not going to do that again. I'm going to probably find somebody else to do that. Yeah. It's the risk is just too great to take a fall, and I would imagine you see a lot of ladder falls.
Daily.
Incredible. Well, we got a little Bruce Springsteen taking us out. We're down three segments, and I've got Dr. Rory Murphy here in the studio. Don't leave us. We got one more segment left. Stick around. We'll be right back.
Now back to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. You're listening to Health Futures, taking stock in you. We're in segment four, and if you're just tuning in, I have got Dr. Rory Murphy here in the studio. He's an independent neurosurgeon at Honor Health Deer Valley Medical Center. He's also an independent member of the Honor Health medical staff. And we've talked about a lot of different things here, and I definitely encourage you to go up to our website to catch this show and many others at cypresshomecare.com. Click on media button, third button down is radio show. You know, one of the things we talked about is being active, and certainly during the break, we were talking about golf. And, you know, I always think about golf, and I'm thinking about the torque on the back. And you know, we talked about Tiger Woods and wanting to swing really hard, and I'm sure there's some injuries there. But you were talking about you're seeing more golf cart injuries than you are seeing, like, diving board and swimming injuries.
Yes, I don't think thankfully, we haven't seen any diving board injuries this year or in the past year. But we do see pretty frequently, once or twice a month, if not more frequently, unfortunately, people falling from golf carts or golf carts rolling, and the injuries can be quite bad.
Wow. I mean, I don't even think about that.
Yeah, I guess you think it's a slower moving vehicle, but some of these golf carts can go 15, 20, 30 miles per hour.
And I don't think I've ever seen one with seatbelts in it.
No. And you can fall out of a golf cart. You're not falling out of a car.
Right. Right. And, you know, just thinking about even falling onto turf, you know, you think that, oh, it's so soft. But, you know, if you've got an aging person that's in their 60s, 70s, or 80s, their bones are brittle, they're fragile. And someone like me, you might be able to respond a little bit better than someone that age.
Correct.
I'm almost that age. How is that?
And some people use golf carts for the majority of their transport. You know, they use it daily for hours every day.
Oh, I see it in Sun City. And I've seen some really bad golf cart accidents on the streets. And that's a scary thing.
Yes.
So I want you to talk a little bit about the neuroscience research that you guys are doing. Well, I think it's really, really incredible, the work that's being done right here in our backyard.
Yeah, I think it is an amazing thing. We can only make things better and, you know, improve quality of health, of people's health, by advancing care. And there's a number of excellent trials being done in Honor Health looking at brain injuries with different medications. So if you have an injury to your head and you have a bruise to your brain, there are two or three drugs now that are potentially able to maybe help reduce the injury to the brain. So we're trialing those. Other excellent initiatives are working on the spine, you know, looking at outcomes, looking at how people do, how we can avoid surgery, who can avoid surgery, and if you do need to operate on someone, who will do well with surgery, and what implants and techniques and what surgical procedures will improve their outcome, maybe get them into the surgery quicker and out of surgery quicker and recovering quicker.
So, you know, talk about TBIs. You know, I think we've learned so much about that. And obviously we know, you know, some famous people that have had injuries and have not lived.
Yes.
You know, if you have a traumatic brain injury, I mean, normal course of action is you know, the brain swells, right? And you know, if you don't get treatment, a lot of people take a knock on the head and they may go to bed and they may not be alive the next day, or they may have some major complications.
And an example of that would be Natasha Richardson's, Liam Neeson's wife.
Exactly.
I think a key thing is, if you are on, blood thinners are very important. They protect your heart, they prevent strokes, and more people are on blood thinners and they're improving quality of life. But if you are on blood thinners and if you do have a fall or hit your head, just get assessed. Just go in. There's no false alarms.
Right.
A scan of the head takes 10 seconds, and it's better to be safer than sorry. And sometimes we also have the situation where someone's on blood thinners, they have a fall, and then actually it's a slower bleed, and people develop the symptoms, could be even a month afterwards. So if family members notice that their loved one is having headaches, nausea, vomiting, increasingly forgetful, stroke-like symptoms, and they're on blood thinners, just bring them into the hospital. It takes half an hour to get them assessed, and it can really prevent big problems.
No, that's really good to know. And you know, when you're talking about blood thinners, how about baby aspirin? Would that be considered a blood thinner? I mean, I know for me, I take one because I have heart. I don't have a heart issue, but I got family heart issues. So my doctor has me on one. But I notice that I sometimes bleed a little bit more, or bruise a little bit more.
Yeah, it would be considered a blood thinner. It's on the lower scale of blood thinners.
Mm-hmm.
But now there are more and more drugs. So traditional ones, aspirin, warfarin. But now there are newer drugs used for AFib and other cardiac issues. And they can cause bleeding and that can be a difficult situation to fix.
So I think the message here to our listeners, if you take a good knock on the head and you're on blood thinners or you're taking baby aspirin, or if you're just not sure, it doesn't cost anything to go get evaluated. Go to the ED and let them know that you took a knock and a rap on the head and have a CT scan.
Yes. And thankfully, most of the time, we'll be just fine. And then if something does happen a week or two later, don't think that just because the initial assessment was fine, that something can't be happening. Sometimes there can be a slower buildup of fluid or blood over 2 or 3 weeks afterwards. And classically, loved ones will say, look, our mother or father or brother or sister is a bit more forgetful. We're not too sure. We can't put our finger on it. And they might have a slow buildup of blood that's kind of causing a bit of pressure on the brain.
And for our listeners, I mean, it if you catch it soon enough, it's not a permanent issue. I mean, you catch it soon enough, you can get treated, and yes, you can go back and live a normal life.
Yes. So soccer fans, Ferguson, the Manchester United coach, he had one. He was dealt with. He's doing very well.
Nice.
Now, unfortunately, Diego Maradona had a subdural hematoma. He didn't do as well, but I think it wasn't, you know, he didn't do as well.
Mm.
But chronic subdurals or bleeds in the brain are very common, and people can do very well afterwards.
And you being from Ireland, being a football fan, I mean, the relevance that you just shared with soccer,
yes,
or American soccer, you never think about there being such injuries in a sport like, you know, European football. I mean, but yes, and they're not wearing a whole lot of protection, are they?
Now, Diego had his injury about a year ago, so he was well past his playing days. He was he's probably, I think Diego Maradona must have been in his mid-60s when he had his bleed, mid-60s to late 60s.
I'm dating myself. I thought he was still playing, but he was pretty awesome.
He was amazing.
Player.
Yes.
Oh yeah. So we got a couple minutes here. Is there a question I haven't asked? Is there a thought that you want to leave our listeners as it relates to the work that you do and really letting them know that there is hope, and we have this mecca here right in our backyard that if you need treatment, you can get it.
Yes. Brain and spine issues are very common. Most of them are not a big issue. Education and lifestyle modifications can fix the vast majority of them. There are some conditions that need to be dealt with straight away. So if you have a bad fall, a fracture, spinal cord compression, weakness in your arms and legs, they need to be looked after straight away. And other things, like if you have a, you know, a trauma or head injury and you're on blood thinners, just come in and get assessed. And the Barrow Brain and Spine Group and Honor Health are doing excellent research to improve the outcomes of people from all those conditions.
No, that's awesome. So we're getting ready to close the segment. What do you got planned for the weekend?
This weekend, spend time with family and then hopefully get some hiking in.
Nice. And have you adopted American football? Or are you a Cardinal fan?
I am. I really enjoy it and basketball too.
And
especially
basketball.
Especially recent events have been disappointing but very exciting.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you what, I don't think anyone expected them to even be there. So, you know, even though we didn't win, I mean, kudos to the Suns. They did a great job.
Yeah. Next year will be even better.
There you go. Next year will be even better. You know, Dr. Rory Murphy, it's really been a pleasure to meet you. And, you know, you have given me hope and certainly our listeners to hope. But is there a phone number or way that we can, you know, get, you know, people to get in touch with you or Honor Health? Neuro 602-258-2863 or email neuroscienceresearch@honorhealth.com. Dr. Rory Murphy, thank you so much for joining us. Make it a great day. Have a great weekend.
Thank you very much, Bob.
There's no place like home. You've been listening to Bob Roth's Health Futures. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call Cypress Home Care Solutions at 602-264-8009. That's 602-264-8009. Or visit cypresshomecare.com. Be sure to join Health Futures with Bob Roth every Friday at noon, right here on Money Radio 1510 and 105.3.